and welcome to this Christmas edition of You So You. My name's Zoe and this is my video series about all the knitting, sewing, crocheting, all the crafts that I get up to. This is the last podcast I'll be doing before Christmas. I am aiming to get one in between Christmas and New Year. But I thought I'd give a quick update before I head off for the festivities about what I've been up to. You can follow me on Instagram at Zosie Mosey. I'm on Ravelry as Zosie M, and there's also a You So You group if you search that in the groups tab on Ravelry. And I have a written blog over at YouSoYou.com. So that's where you can find me at the festive period and any other time as well. So let's get right to it. Well, first of all, you may recognise this little number. This is the first ever adult jumper that I knitted for myself. As you can see, it's got cabling and a shawl collar. If you remember, when I came across this the other week, it had actually shrunk quite considerably and I was a bit worried about whether or not it would be wearable. So I've reblocked it. It's actually cotton, so I wasn't sure how well it would reblock out. Actually, I say reblock out, it was never blocked in the first place. But I knitted it before I knew how to care for hand knits, really. So it was washed too hot, it shrunk slightly. It always was a cropped jumper, but I couldn't actually get it on. It was the arms that were causing most of the problem. As you can see, I can now wear it. I can raise my arms. It is a little tighter around the arms than is ideal, so I may or may not see if I can undo the seams and fix that, as it was knitted in the flat. To see if I can do something about the points that are appearing on the shoulder. I think that's more of a pinning when I blocked it than anything else. So yes, it's a cropped jumper. It's always been about that long, so above the waistband of my jeans. So it's good with these longer vests, high-waisted trousers, and it's great over dresses. But I quite like the length on me for in those sorts of circumstances. It does ride up a bit, and I do need to when I lift my arms above my head. But in all honesty, if I'm not in the supermarket, when am I going to be lifting my arms over my head? So yes, this has been salvaged. It's wearable. As I say, it's a little bit tight around the biceps, but it's not painful to wear. It's not totally uncomfortable. I'm fairly sure it will ease out with a bit of wear and soften up a little bit. So yay for the power of blocking. That's definitely a win. And I may well see if I can find this pattern or reverse engineer it maybe, and re-knit it in a different yarn and a slightly larger size possibly, so that I can have a bit more length to wear with my shorter trousers and skirts and things, maybe a bit longer sleeves, although I do like this sleeve length. I think for the winter a full length sleeve would be good. I can't remember who designed it. It came free with the magazine a long time ago, but I do really like it. I'm really proud of it. It is the first adult jumper I ever knitted, and I can wear it again. Yay! So that's what I'm wearing. I do actually have a finished object for you as well. I was hoping to get some projects finished by Christmas, and I have managed to get one project finished before Christmas. Obviously, it is very nearly the day itself. I don't think I'm going to get anything else finished in time for Christmas itself. Massive surprise, and you'll see why when I get to my work in progress. But I have finished not one, but two socks. These are in the Paint Box yarns, and this is lovely brown and green colourway. These are not from any particular pattern. I've kind of made it up as I go along. They were a little on the tight side pre-blocking, but now that they're blocked out, I think they're going to be fine. They fit in my block nicely, and this is the right size for my feet, so I'm pretty hopeful that blocking will have done the trick. I will let you know once I've worn them for longer than a couple of minutes at a time, just to try them on. So I have done a long wedge toe to begin with. I knitted them toe up two at a time. I have Vickle braids splitting the socks up into bands. I have a diamond attempt here. I have some moss stitch here. I attempted a chevron pattern and failed miserably here. I revised my diamond pattern here and I've echoed it around the back of the sock for the top half of the diamonds there. Another moss stitch band. And then I've done this wonderful smocked 2x2 rib. Hopefully that's showing up for you there. I know it's a bit of a dark yarn to be showing off patterns. You can see a slight jog here. That's where my Vickle braids are joining. I haven't quite worked out how to do them toe-to-time socks without that jog. I mean, we're getting better as we go up. And if I show you the other side of the sock, where the Vickle braid has just continued around the side, you don't get any of that jog. So I quite like the idea of the band, so I just need to finesse it slightly. And I've done an eye of partridge on the heel flap, but I did mess up the counts and the on the gussets. I increased too quick, so the heel numbers need a bit of reworking. But as a first attempt at coming up with a sock pattern, I'm fairly pleased. I mean, it's not like I would be sharing it with anybody yet in terms of instructions. It's not yet at that point. There's a lot of tweaking and reworking to do before I even contemplated doing that. Whether or not I will write it up as a proper pattern and release it, I have no idea. It's not on the horizon at the moment. But yes, socks to my own specifications. Woohoo! That's done. Finished object. Yay! In time for Christmas. I'll be wearing those whilst I'm away at my dad's. And then we get to the works in progress. I have one project that you've seen before that I've made quite a bit of progress on. This is a deadline knit. It's a test knit for Mina Phillip, the Knitting Expat. It's her big red pattern. I'm doing it in blue. So here we have big blue, using the big red pattern. And as you can see from my progress marker here, I have made quite a bit of progress on the body. I am just about to start the travelling cables that will bring the line back in. Jumper in stripes, the cable, the raglan down the sides, and then the cable's going to curve back in again. So I'm just about to start curving that back in, and then it'll be picking up for the neck and doing the sleeves, which will be a plain stripe. So that's going to be quite doable. I say it's not going to be done by Christmas, but it's going to be done in plenty of time for the deadline in the middle of January. So that's all on track. It's in Cascade 220 fingering weight, which is quite nice, soft, easy to work with. It's a super washable, so I'm expecting it to grow a little bit in length once I block it out. But that's no. The next one I've talked about, but I haven't changed it. I cast it on the other day. This is a birthday knit. My other half turns older between Christmas and me. I'm not going to say his age because he'd kill me. But his birthday is on the 30th of December. I decided I'm going to start knitting things for his birthday. So I cast this on the other day. It's going to be a jumper for him. It may not be done quite in time for his birthday, but we kind of come up with a plan quite late. So this is the Erica Knight Forest Hill pattern. It's in Aran weight. It looks quite narrow for a man's jumper, but he is quite slender. He's also quite tall, so I am modifying the length measurements. I'm knitting the smaller size circumference for the chest measurements. I've cast on the smallest number of stitches, but I'm going to be knitting to the large length, which is the second to largest size, and I will be knitting the sleeves longer than any of the sizes in the pattern, just to make sure that it fits him properly. So we've got cables, we've got a zigzag purl pattern going on, and a bit of moss stitch at the side. So it's quite an enjoyable knit. It's a 16 row repeat. So this is two repeats. So yeah, it's knitting up quite quickly. This will be the back, knitting the flat, then seamed. So we'll see how close I am to finishing it before his birthday, just before New Year. So that's new cast on number one. New cast on number two, I cast on yesterday. It's a baby project at the moment. It is in seasonal yarn. It's in the Christmas colourway from, if I just get the label, Fairy Realm Yarns. It's in that merino nylon, so it's a superwash merino nylon fingering sock weight in the Christmas tree colourway. I am doing my first pair of contrast toes, heels, possibly cuffs if I have enough socks. So I've got the toes cast on in this lovely curly pink that came as a mini with the sock set, and then this green colourway with splashes of whites and purples and pinks just creeping in now as I start to work on the foot. I'm doing these to Mina Phillips' Candy Cane sock pattern, which is the free pattern that comes with the Season Sock Club, which starts in January. So that's underway, and I have on here my Christmas tree progress keeper that came with the yarn. And I'm knitting on my usual sock needles. These are higher sharps. I knit 68 stitches on 2.5 millimeter needles. That's US size 1.5, I want to say. My sock needle size is probably not the same as yours. I knit to 8 stitches per inch on my socks. I'm a UK size 7. I need 68 stitches to get the right circumference on that gauge. And I'm quite pleased with the fabric and the fit and the way it all turns out. So I'm going to keep going with that. Now, I don't actually have anything else to show you today. Any sewing to show you or anything like that. I may get some sewing projects done in the betwixtmas period, so I do have another Minerva blog to get done with some gorgeous yellow floral scuba that I may or may not have showed you last week. I think it had arrived by then. But I've been focusing on the knitting to get things out of the way before deadlines, and then that betwixtmas period will be a little bit more knitting to get the birthday jumper done, and some sewing to get the Minerva project out of the way. And I've got a hoodie that I want to make as well, out of some kind of purpley burgundy sweatshirting, which I know I've shown you before, the pink speckly contrast fabric. So that's my plans for betwixtmas, so I will update you with that in about a week's time. Might not have stuff finished by then, but things should be underway. I am off for my Christmas hijinks on Monday. I'm filming Saturday evening, and I'm going to be uploading on Sunday. Before I go, my presents are wrapped. I should put everything in the suitcase. And I'm off to my dad's for Christmas, which will be good. Hopefully my brother will be making an appearance at some point, because I'd love to see his face when he opens his presents. But we'll see. I may or may not get some filming done whilst I'm away. It might just be another two camera podcast on my return. But there will be progress on socks, there will be progress on the big red, there'll be progress on the birthday jumper. Which you'll see the projects that I've got that I've shown you today that are in progress, and that there should be some sewing started. So in the meantime, have a wonderful Christmas. For those of you who celebrate, and those of you who don't, have a restful couple of days. And I will see you in betwixtmas, just before we end 2018 and head into the next year. Until then, have a great one. Bye bye.